Okay, so good morning, everybody. We are at the Mauna Kea Aloha Aina TMT opposition protest. Today is the day that they're going to do the groundbreaking for the 30-meter telescope on Mauna Kea, which is a sacred mountain to most folks here. It's kind of a long story that we will get into, but in the meantime, I'm going to take a little lay of the land here at the beginning. Hello, Mr. Fred.
Hey, hi.
How are you?
Good.
Nice to see you. Hello, Auntie. I'm good. How are you? You're welcome. We're streaming right now. Let's get a little lay of the land here quick. All right. Well, it's like, okay, the ceremony is over. So I'm going to walk across the street for a minute, but I will be back. Okay. Oh, another Mauna Kea Summit adventure. Lucky you. There's nobody in that van. And a tourist. I want to see how this goes. Wait, I want to see how this goes. A tourist is going to drive right on by. And J12. Everybody. This is like the biggest deal in astronomy this year is that they're going to build a 30-meter telescope on a sacred mountain. And actually, it's already not the biggest telescope in the world. There's supposed to be a super extra large European one that's going to be 42 meters across. So 32 meters. Mr. Bob!
How you doing?
How are you?
That
is pretty awesome. They should Google it. If you don't know what ole means, you should Google it. A lot of times when I'm Googling Hawaiian words, to you other folks that have to Google stuff like I do, if you put the word Hawaiian and then whatever you see there, either with or without the punctuation marks, ole means no. And this is Mr. Bob Ernst. He is a Hawaii hero of activism and smartness. Bob knows a lot about energy stuffs, and so we like him very much. And look how pretty the mountain this morning. You know what? I've driven up over here probably 3 or 4 times in the last couple of weeks, and every time she was behind clouds, or at least it's a little hazy.
It's a shame. Well, it could be this, no, but it's a shame that it's so beautiful for the desecration.
It's an awful desecration. Okay, so the troops are gathering, and I'm making the rounds, so I'll tell you what, I will come back in a little bit, but we're streaming a little bit just to make sure we get something up and to show the world that this is a peaceful demonstration, that we have all kinds of aloha, don't we? It's all about aloha.
It's too bad the politicians didn't have aloha.
Aloha, yes. Beyond them. That's what you get for aloha from the man is... Why are they even there? They're letting tourists and stuff go through.
Oh, yeah.
So we can just drive on up there?
I think we're very nice.
They're just to watch us?
I had the sign out here.
Okay, it's not a block then.
No.
Okay.
They're just watching us.
Okay, cool. All right, there's nothing to see. We're cool. Mrs. Bob. Mwah. How are you, darling?
Fine, thank you.
Watching. This is, okay, so if you're on Twitter too, the hashtag that the folks are promoting is called Building TMT. So if you search Building TMT, you will find all of the official posts, plus several many of ours. Aloha Aina is another hashtag you can search. And what else? Caltech is one of the people putting this on. Oh, it's windy again, isn't it? Sorry. Meant to grab a sock or something. Yeah. Bulldoze ground chapel. How about that? we are going to run across the highway. There, that is the Royal Order of Kamehameha doing their ceremony. It's their ahu. So they're doing prayers every hour on the hour, starting at 8 a.m. until 2 o'clock, because I think that's how long we think the thing's going to last. Starts at noon, goes till 2. Let's see if they want to talk to us for a second. Is it too windy? Mr. Nelson!
You everywhere.
Well, we try. We try to be.
It is beautiful.
It's a really, really awesome day.
Yeah.
It's an awesome turnout. It's sort of
almost 300.
Is it?
Yeah, I counted.
Cool.
This morning.
Cool.
It has been up the Mauna. Aloha.
Morning.
Aloha. Good
morning, Gary.
Aloha.
Nice to see you.
Aloha.
Thank you for bringing me over.
Hello.
Nice to see you.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Good to see you.
It's about, 9:30 whatever in the morning, which means they've done 2 rounds of ceremony. I don't know if you can see it, but I see cars going up the mountain. You can see the reflection of their windshields on the road. Okay, so in the past, many years ago, they went and put a telescope up there, and people were sad about that. But they had a lease for one telescope, so they put it. And then in the ensuing, 30 years, they put 13 more, I think, up there. And basically all of them are illegal, unpermitted, unwanted things by the local community. The astronomy community loves them. Hawaii Island is a wonderful place to do astronomy because of the conical shape of the island and the fact that we are very, very far from other civilization type things. We don't have a lot of light pollution. The air is very calm. And so it's a great place to put optics to look out into space where there's not a lot of disturbance from the air, so they can get really good images and stuff. So that's why they want to put it there. Hello. Live stream. I'm talking to myself. Explaining to the viewers at home. You're welcome. Okay, so that's why the astronomy people want to put it here. Why the Hawaiian and environmentalists and everybody else that doesn't want it put here doesn't want it put here is because it is a restricted conservation zone, for one thing. It's supposed to be undeveloped, basically. I mean, why do you even designate conservation areas if you're just gonna go, you know, bulldoze them and build on them anyway? And so the 30 meter telescope that they're planning to put up there will have a base 6 or 8 acres large. And they're gonna put it on the northern plateau. So it's actually on the opposite side of what we're looking at here on the mountain. It'll be down the plain a little bit, because the top is full. The summit is full of telescopes. There's no more room up there for it because they've already taken all the room. So that's why they're putting it on the northern plain, and they will scrape out a big flat spot and dig down, I think, 4 stories. The Keck telescope that's up there has a 7-story basement underneath it. This one will have 4. So much for the conservation district. They're going to dig out 4 stories of stuff and build an 18-story tall telescope on top of it. So you'll be able to see it from pretty much the whole north side of the island for sure, probably the west side. I don't think we'll be able to see it from Hilo because it'll be just down over the top of the summit there, so on the back side. So that's the deal. It's super large. It's too big. It's actually not even the biggest telescope in the world already. There is a European telescope. If you search EELT, you will find that the European folks are planning to build a 42-meter telescope. So they haven't even broken ground on this yet. That's what's happening today. And then it will take them like 5 or 10 years to actually build it. And by the time it's done, it's already outdated. But they've already poured millions and billions of dollars into the engineering and the science. They've been building mirrors for it. That's another thing too. This is technically Hawaii, a sovereign nation that was annexed without any permission or ceremony or anything by the United States. So there's that way of looking at it. And then also, the United States, if you think this is the United States, isn't even a partner in the TMT. China is, and India is, and they're doing some of the work in UC Cal Berkeley, I think? I forget. One of the California universities is doing some of the research and whatnot, but mostly this is a foreign affair. So when they talk about it bringing jobs and, you know, wonderful economic stuff to this island, they're lying, because no money has come to this island. There aren't people here that know how to make an 18-story dome, nor do we have the raw materials to make that happen. So all that money is being spent elsewhere, and the benefits are being reaped elsewhere. We'll probably have some construction crews that'll make some money. They'll get to pour some slabs and make some driveways. And I heard Nelson said he counted 300 at one point.
We were a little after 8. Yeah. But when we even arrived, it was a sea of people before at 7:30. It was a wonderful thing.
I've had a really good feeling since like middle of the day yesterday about this. I had a lot of dread and trepidation and weirdness up till like yesterday. And then I woke up this morning at like 5 o'clock. I was so excited. But then I still didn't get here till an hour ago.
It was nice.
So, do you have the time? Perhaps, do you know where we are?
Must be about 9:30.
Like half past a freckle?
Yeah?
Okay, so we've got a little time before they go again.
I'll tell you that I was first here.
Yes.
At 9:30 last night.
Were you?
It was completely socked in. You couldn't see the pool from here.
Yeah.
In about an hour or so, it lifted. Sky opened up. Like this, clear air, beautiful high clouds, and a brilliant full moon, or almost full moon.
That's cool.
Thank you.
She's going to explain. This is Lalani. Say aloha, Lalani.
Aloha, everybody. So when this starts, you'd be able to see it from down here. There's the area up here is Kapu to video, so you won't be able to go up into the area because it's disturbing to, you know, the cultural practice, but from down here you should be able to see it's been nice and loud and strong, so
right on.
It's still very powerful from here.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
For explaining.
And,
that
mahalo everybody, and don't forget, if you can take a selfie of yourself with the Tech Mauna Kea sign. Those have been collected on Facebook. And if you guys use Facebook, you can. I'm trying to remember what the group name is. You can post it to the Protect.
If you search Mauna Kea on Facebook,
well,
for the groups,
there's just too many. But there's okay. there's the Protect Mauna Kea page, or there's you can email it to me, laulani@gmail.com, or Facebook me, Laulani Teal. Just find me. You're probably mostly my Facebook friends anyway. But yeah, and then I'll get it to these guys, because yeah, we're collecting pictures of people holding a message, whatever message you want to send for the protection of Mauna Kea, and you know, putting them together. And it'd be really awesome to get people from different areas.
Yes, because we know we have people standing with us in New York City and Palo Alto and Oregon for sure.
Yeah.
And Mount Fuji, hopefully.
Mount Fuji.
Most of the islands. We have a lot of
reunions are going on everywhere. It's pretty, pretty beautiful. It's been a good day.
Okay, let's see. Okay, here's my...
Okay, looks like they're going to start the next ceremony. So I'm not going to talk, and we're just going to view. I hope you can hear okay with all the wind. All right. Still watching, are you? Okay. We're going to walk away from the ceremonial area and I will explain stuff. Okay, so. If you are just tuning in, this is the protest against the 30 meter telescope. Okay, wait. Okay, so what happened is I just left the stream running there on the ground and I went to the top of the mountain. We drove up, not to the tippy top, but we went to the visitor information center because I went to fetch my camera with the good windsock here, see? And when I got to my car over there, I realized that the cops that were over here were gone all of a sudden, all of them. And we didn't know why or what was happening up the hill, so we just took off and went up the hill. And what happened was there was a little bit of road blocking, apparently, and they have a tow truck up there. So if anybody pulls their car out to block the road, they can just pull it off. And they're probably not even going to tow it downhill, they're just going to pull it off. So there's no blocking the road with cars. So I think some people were blocking the road. And that lasted for only a little while. And then and when we got up there, everything was pretty calm, you know, and a lot of people are taking off. It is what, a quarter to 11, and the official ceremony for the groundbreaking of the TMT, the 30-meter telescope, starts at noon. So we got a little over an hour. And a lot of the people that were up there protesting have already gotten into trucks, and they're going up to the tippy top of the mountain, and there will probably be ceremonies and whatnot up there. I missed my ride, I think. I'm not sure, I can't find her. So I can either still catch a ride up to the tippy top or not. But we came back down to fetch the live stream here, and our friend over there that we left here, because we took off. Okay, so that's what just happened. Thanks everybody for watching and checking in. And does anybody have any questions? Or I don't know what we're gonna do next. We were feeling like what was happening at the visitor center was not really happening anymore, because a lot of people had left to go up to the top, and then there's this ceremony happening down here at the saddle. So we decided to come back down and fetch the camera and fetch the friend and check in with each other and see where we want to go next. But, so there you go, you're updated. That is what's going on here. Aloha.